Hey BC, what's up? It's me, yours truly. I am back to post a really quick video here. Actually about to run out to a hockey game here in a minute and thought, let me knock this video out really quick because it won't take very long, and I told him I was going to do it. And this is actually a video for Dimebag. He requested that I show my, or do a give me 10 for my comedy albums. Quite frankly, I'm not that engulfed in my comedy albums where I can really do like a top 10. And I don't have a lot of them either, so I thought I'll just kind of do a quick video. I'll just show them all really quick. So, again, this is for Dime. And it is one of those, I guess, genres that we don't talk about that much in the BC, so I thought it might be good to do a quick video. So, Dime, this is for you. This is what I have in my comedy album section. Now, I mean, I do listen to these, and I've listened to every single album all the way through, because again, I put nothing in my collection that I don't actually like and will go back and listen to again. So let's just kind of jump into that. George Carlin. This is Class Clown. I love George Carlin. I mean, I remember seeing one of his stand-ups when I was younger, and I can't remember the name of the life of me, but I don't know. I never agreed with all of his views on things, but just in general, he was a nut, and sometimes he was really funny, sometimes he wasn't funny at all, but I liked him a lot. I consider this kind of comedy, too. Chipmunks, Hollywood, where they basically do a bunch of covers of different songs like Eye of the Tiger, 9 to 5, theme from The Greatest American Hero, Chariots of Fire, The Dukes of Hazzard, and again, it's fun stuff to listen to. I've actually spun that record a number of times. Then you go into the genius himself. You talk about a man that I respect to the utmost. It's Bill Cosby. I mean, the guy is a genius. The guy is so intelligent. The guy had, I mean, a great, clean career. I mean, there's just so many things I respect about this man. But this is Why Is There Air? And then you got more Cosby here. This is one you tend to see a lot, actually. So I do, and I stumble across it a lot. But Wonderfulness. And this is Join Bill Cosby in Revenge. Or I guess it's just called Revenge, but and you got more Cosby here. To Russell, My Brother, and Flip With. And the best of Bill Cosby. Next tier, probably one of his most classic stand-ups, I think, ever. I definitely like the actual video, or the DVD or whatever, but Bill Cosby himself, that was a classic right there. I think that this was Cosby at one of his peaks. So, good stuff. More Cosby here. Got Cosby and the Kids. And then we move on to, I just showed this in a video last night, Rodney Dangerfield. And this, of course, No Respect. Everyone knows all that stuff about Rodney with that. I'm getting these backwards, hold on. Make sure I keep them in order there. And I figure Don't Worry, Be Happy be a good background song to play for a comedy video. Then you got more Rodney here, which is Rapping Rodney. I'm sure you guys remember that video too. Rodney was another genius too. He was just a guy that was just naturally funny. You know, you could take a line that somebody else could say and it means nothing, and Rodney could say the exact same line and he just had you dying with those big bug eyes and his expressions and mannerisms. And the guy, again, another guy that was just a genius in my book. All in the Family, one of the great groundbreaking TV series right there. What's his name? I always forget his freaking name. I don't know. The character Archie that he played was absolute genius. It's really hard to believe that wasn't really him. I mean, that's just how much he took over that character. But again, it's just some different clips from different shows. I don't know if it's necessarily a comedy, because I jammed this album actually, but I have it in my comedy section, which is Sesame Street Fever. Has my jam, which is C is for Cookie by the Cookie Monster. Love that song. Matter of fact, that's staying out. I'm going to play it as soon as this video is over. No, actually, screw that. I'm going to play it right now. I don't want to deprive you guys of being able to listen to it, so hold on 1 second. Let's get a little C.S. for Cookie going on in the background here. So let's stop that. Turn that on. There we go. Alright. Do it, Cookie Monster. Alright. I consider this comedy too. I bought it in a Goodwill shop, and I ended up, you know, I had to hear it, and when I did, I could not stop laughing. And every time I listen to it, it cracks me up. But more jazzercise. Oh my gosh, these things are so funny. That's why I put them in my comedy section. Whoopi Goldberg. This was from her Broadway, one of her Broadway stand-up, which again was one of the first things I saw from her was her. Was it called Whoopi Goldberg Live on Broadway? Which again was just a great, great stand-up that she did. Even though I hate her, I do give her props on her early stand-up comedy. She was really good. And even her acting in general. I mean, stuff like Color Purple and everything else, she is, I mean, genius, absolutely fantastic. I just hate her. I hate her views. I hate, you know, just the way her mind works. I hate everything about that woman, except her gifts. Hate's a strong word, too. I'm just kind of messing around there, but I don't like her a lot. Let's put it that way. More comedy. Eddie Murphy. Classic Eddie here. I mean, you can just look at the titles of his song, or his tracks, and you got what? Faggot, Butt Week, Black Movie Theaters, Talking Cars, Doo Doo, Christmas Gifts, Boogie in Your Butt. I mean, just stupid stuff. The Pope and Ronald Reagan. Those crazy Eddie years. And then in my mind, the funniest man, dead or alive, to ever touch the face of this earth. The one and only Richard Pryor. Oh my goodness. Does not get any funnier than this. And this one is There Something I Said? Okay album for him. Then you move on to Richard Pryor, Wanted. Again, definitely want a decent album. But then, in my opinion, you move on to the genius of Richard Pryor, which is his two best stand-ups ever. Live on the Sunset Strip. Which, very interesting about this, too. This was after his comeback. I think when he, you know, burned himself up when he was freebasing and everything. And I guess he did, like, I don't know if it was 1 weekend or a couple weekends. But if you've ever seen the DVD, you know it's one of his best stand-ups ever. But what a lot of people don't know is he did a show the night before, and he completely and totally bombed the show. I mean, he walked off the stage early. He apologized to everybody for how bad it was. And, you know, so to take that kind of hit up on stage in front of all these people after you're trying to make a comeback from the worst screw-up of your life, and the very next night turn it into one of the most incredible things you've ever done in your career, that's the genius of Richard Pryor. And so, yeah, one of his best stand-ups, and probably his second best, if not his best, again, Richard Pryor Here and Now. Love this one, too. The thing that made Richard so awesome was that he had this ability to look at life and see comedy in everything in life. I mean, there's very few people in the world, I think, that could take, I was a total drug addict, and I end up almost killing myself and burning myself to death doing drugs. I see a lot of funny stuff in that. Let me make up a whole 15-minute bit that has the world dying about the worst moment in my life. I mean, most, the human mind isn't made to think that way, but that's how you get the comic geniuses like Richard Pryor, because he was able to do that. Anything he saw in life would have comedy in it. But Richard Pryor, Greatest Hits, another kind of mixture of different things. And then the last two here, Monty Python, The Life of Brian. I don't know if you guys like Monty Python, but like The Life of Brian and The Holy Grail are two of my favorite movies by them. So this is kind of the soundtrack with snippets from the movie. Oh man, I love those two movies. Those guys are hilarious. And last but not least, Flatten Your Tummy, same as the Jazzercise. Part of it had to listen to it, cracked me up, and I've actually listened to it a couple times when I need a good laugh. So anyway, there you go, Dime. I guess you won't call this a Give Me 10, but just wanted to show those comedy records for you. And as always, BC, we will talk to you soon. Take care, guys.